Hi, welcome back, and thanks for sticking with us, through this KNX AV, conference. I think it's a conference, it's an expo, it's a community, it's a little bit of everything, and there's some contests here that you can join in and take away a few prizes. So, thank you for joining. Now we are going to be talking about integrating AV applications into KNX. We have with us Johannes Geis, who is the, he's been working for a long time, for more than 10 years at WineZero GmbH in as software development, working in embedded software, developing those KNX system software stacks for some time. And he's going to be talking about how we're going to proceed with integrating non-KNX applications into the KNX system that WineZero has, developed, and they have their KNX BAOS architecture. This is a broad range of KNX modules and gateways allowing manufacturers to add KNX connectivity to their products. So, welcome, Johannes.
Thank you very much. I hope everyone can hear me. Well, welcome to the integration of audio and video applications into KNX. My name is Johannes Geis, and I'm a software developer for the KNX system stack. Let's take a look at the agenda of this presentation. The first part is a short introduction to our company. Then we talk about audio-video control in KNX. Our solution to bring application to the KNX network is called BAOS. We talk about this later and how to use this to control audio-video. The fourth topic covers our hardware solutions, which implement the BAOS protocol. And at last, we take a quick look at the ETS database, the most important part for commissioners to configure various devices to work together. Let me introduce our company. WineZero Engineering was founded 20 years ago in 2001. We are located in the countryside near Burgkirchen an der Alz, which is in the southeast part of Bavaria in Germany, about 110 kilometers southeast of Munich. Here, we develop hardware and software for building automation, mainly KNX. Our products are KNX devices for the end customer and modules for companies who want to connect their devices to the KNX bus. The modules and devices take care about all of the ISO OSI network layers and the system management of KNX. They offer an application interface to easily integrate the customer's application without the need of knowledge about the KNX network stack. Furthermore, we offer software tools like NetNode to monitor, send, and receive data on the KNX bus and tools for application software development. For customers, we offer system solutions for KNX with hardware modules containing the KNX system stack software and a KNX stack, which is a software-only solution. Both with software tools for developers. As a service, we also offer hardware and software development for customers and a test laboratory to certificate a finished KNX device. This is necessary to get the permission to bear the KNX logo, which ensures compatibility with other KNX devices. Let's take a look to the KNX control for audio and video. Controlling audio-video should be integrated into the building control. Due to the KNX standard, it is possible to use switches designed for audio and video control, as well as standard switches. Also a lot of other sensors and actuators. Visualization for such controls can be made by the customer who gets the information over the KNX bus. The KNX infrastructures optionally offers integration into so-called scenes. These scenes can determine a certain setup of different KNX devices like lights, shutters, volume control, and so on in one scene. Timers are available to configure delayed actions like automatically switching off a light or mute audio. With the usage of the KNX topology, the audio-video control can be accessed remotely via all KNX media like twisted pair, radio frequency, and TCP/IP. The audio-video standard for KNX is specified in volume number 7, the application specification. Part 70 specifies the audio-video part. Its chapter describes the interworking, the KNX data point types for audio-video, which are in line with other applications like dimming. The data point specification is an important part in the KNX standard. It ensures that KNX devices from different manufacturers are compatible. Access to the KNX bus is possible for applications via different interfaces. Our modules and devices offer a UART serial interface. Some devices, a TCP/IP interface, others, a USB interface, and one is over Wi-Fi. These interfaces offer access to different ISO OSI layers of the KNX stack. We can here see the different layers the KNX stack have. The most convenient access is the BIOS protocol, which exchange information via data points or communication objects, which is just another name for data points. This way, the application has not to take care about KNX telegrams, addressing devices and management. If a low-level access to the KNX bus is necessary, the BIOS protocol offers access to the link layer of the communication stack. This way, the application must take care about nearly all aspects of a KNX telegram by itself, which we recommend only in exceptions. The ETS, the configuration software of the KNX Association for Commissioning Devices, can also use the interface of our devices. They offer access via USB or IP to the KNX bus. So the devices can be used as a KNX interface for the ETS. In the last few slides, I mentioned the BIOS protocol. What is BIOS? It is a bus access and object server, an application which offers a protocol to the customer application to read and write data points. These data points or communication objects are simply set variables for storing values like on-off, up-down, values for certain controls like volume, strings, and so on. If such a variable is changed by the customer application, it generates a KNX telegram according to the ETS configuration. The other way around is a KNX telegram which changes the value. In this case, the BIOS protocol informs the customer application about this change. BIOS offers, as I said before, a low-level access at Telegram level to the KNX bus. This can be used as programming interface for the ETS. We recommend usage of the access at object level, which is the access to the data points. The BIOS devices come with different extensions like maximum numbers of data points or an integrated web server. These devices are a universal IP gateway for building automation. They can offer a local gateway to your home to access all KNX devices in the building via a customer device like an iOS or Android tablet. Of course, also a normal computer, whatever you want. The modules and devices offer a fast integration of a customer non-KNX device into the KNX network. The application areas for BIOS are connecting the customer devices to the KNX network without a deep knowledge about KNX. Access to all kinds of sensors and actuators are possible, like heating, ventilation, audio video, lights, and more. The advantage is a lower investment when a customer takes the first step into the KNX world. It speeds up the development since the KNX stack and system management is already implemented in the BIOS module. This KNX stack is already certified. The typical usage for this approach is for quantities of about 1,000 devices or less, since it uses two PCBs, our module and the customers, which contain its own controller. Another typical use case is to have a modular design of the customer device, which use modules to connect to different network systems like KNX, Modbus, BACnet, and so on. The ETS product database of the BIOS modules and devices is available as a generic one. This database is for developers a possibility to quickly configure the BIOS module or device while development. An individual database is possible to be created by the customer. This database reflects the features of the final device and is more usable for a commissioner. BIOS integrates the KNX system by taking care about the KNX telegrams, the management part, which is used by the ETS, and the application side. The application side can be the access to the data points or to a web server, which can be accessed with computers, smartphones, tablets, and others. This web server is a special feature of our 777 device. The central part of the object protocol is the object server. It manages the bus access and communication to the customer application via the BIOS protocol. It separates the KNX handling from the customer application. The client communicates to the object server via BIOS protocol, mainly with data points, the variables as I mentioned before. The client needs no knowledge about KNX telegrams. The BIOS data which the client accesses are data points, which I mentioned earlier. These data points are the variables the client can read or write. If it changes the value, a KNX telegram is automatically sent if configured. If a value is changed by a KNX telegram, the client will be informed. ETS can set some parameters at configuration time. These parameters can be read by the customer application. The meaning of such parameters are at the discretion of the customer. So you can put into them whatever you want. These parameters are normally read at the startup of the application. Server items are BIOS module or device related variables. They reflect internal stages of the device, like uptime, programming mode, or serial number. The advantage of the object server is to take care about the values of the data points, even if the customer application is not running or connected. It does not require a group value read at startup of the customer application, since the value are already valid. And short latencies ensure a tight data exchange of the KNX network and the client. Let's take a quick deeper look at the BIOS protocol. As we already saw, it accesses mainly the communication objects or data points. The access to the data points are done by a set of protocol commands. The get data point value request is for reading certain communication objects. The get data point value response is the answer to this request. If a data point is changed by the KNX bus, it informs the client with a data point value indication. This indication comes automatically. To change a value of a communication object, set data point value request response are used. These are these two commands. And at last, to read the parameters which are set by ETS, a get parameter byte request response are used. The parameters are normally set by ETS and only read by the application. That's for now enough to look into the BIOS protocol and take a look at the hardware. The BIOS modules contain one microcontroller and a KNX transceiver. The controller contains the certified KNX stack and the object server. This software is a closed source software. Up to 1,000 data points can be used as communication object. For a more technical approach, an interface to the link layer is offered. Such an interface is an access to Telegram level. This I already mentioned before. The interface to the client uses a UART serial interface. This encapsulates the BIOS protocol or the low-level access with an FT1.2 protocol to ensure a reliable serial communication. This encapsulation protocol is only used for UART serial interface. All other protocols like TCP/IP have their own encapsulation. The modules come with a certified KNX stack. Most of them use the twisted pair medium as KNX bus, and they are available with or without galvanic isolation. The isolation protects the customer device from spike disturbances on the KNX bus. This way, the customer device must have its own power supply. Without the isolation, the device is powered by the bus, which is only recommended for small devices which do not consume much power. For the Raspberry Pi, we offer the same BIOS module in a different form factor. It can be used by Raspberry Pi 1, 2, 3, and 4. And one of our BIOS modules uses the KNX radio frequency medium. The USB interface can be used as a common interface to the KNX bus. It supports long frames, which speed up the communication, especially by using ETS. And it has an improved user interface, which indicates bus errors with a red LED in front of it. Since it offers a BIOS object server, it can be used to connect non-KNX devices to the KNX world. So this can also be used to integrate audio-video control. The USB stick is the same device like the device before, except for its form factor. The IP BIOS devices use an Ethernet interface. They can connect up to 5 clients simultaneously. They are powered by the KNX bus and can also indicate bus errors like the last two devices. The BIOS protocol is usable over TCP/IP. The 773 supports up to 250 data points and the 774 up to 1000 data points. And as usual, they also can be used to integrate audio-video control. The IP BIOS 777 is the biggest BIOS device we currently have. It acts as a universal IP gateway in your home. It can be used as a KNX IP interface to access the KNX Twisted Pair bus. This can be used by the ETS. The BIOS object server offers up to 2000 data points, and a web server is integrated for visualization and control. This device can be configured by ETS as well as by its web server. It features additionally an NTP timer, history of data activity, and email notification. And it comes with a generic and a structured ETS database. The web server of the BIOS IP 777 can be used by any web browsers on a computer, mobile device like iPhone or an Android-based phone or tablet. Using JSON and an API, the customer can program the web services. I don't want to get more technical at this point. More information about this are available at our website. All BIOS modules and devices come with a generic ETS database, which is a flat list of data points. This is for developers to get a quick start. The BIOS 777 additionally offers a structured ETS database, which can be configured with the web server. This database is structured with rooms, with enable functions, with data points, and generation of semantic informations like visualization. A tailored individual database can be done by the customer. The generic database is for a quick start. It looks like this. There are some data points which have been made available with a given name. The first data point here is a binary switch with the name play stop as an example to play or stop an audio device. The third one is one byte. It's in this example used as a volume control for this device. All data points can be enabled and assigned to different data points with different sizes like 16-bit, 32-bit, float, strings, etc. All these types, the KNX specification tells you about. The individual ETS database is a customer-made database. It reflects the features of the customer device. Here we have an example for an individual customer database we created as a service for Revox. So this database is more friendly for commissioners. This slide shows the database, the data points of the individual database, which have been made available by ETS on the previous slide. They can be connected in the usual way to KNX group objects, and this is the task of the commissioner. This way, he can connect audio-video controls like volume, start, stop, and so on. Last but not least, we deliver a tool named NetNode to all our customers. This tool can monitor the KNX bus as well as send some telegrams, query KNX devices, and so on. It makes the development much more easier for developers because they can see what is happening on the bus. Like the diagnosis tools in ETS, but furthermore, it can send telegrams and it can analyze the KNX devices, whatever you like to do. It can use multiple interfaces simultaneously. These interfaces can be USB, IP, and a serial port. NetNode is able to manage all and monitor all KNX media, like twisted pair, even power line, radio frequency, and IP. And as a specialty, it can handle the BIOS protocol, which is a great help for developers. This way, audio-video control can be used the same way like all other building controls. The BIOS protocol is just our solution we offer to you. That's for now all about audio-video control integration with BIOS. If you need more information, visit our website at weinziel.de or send an email to info@weinziel.de. Thank you for your attention.
Hi, Johannes, that was great. Thank you very much.